The last thing to understand about data is the different types of data that we can encounter. So depending on what information was collected or how that information was collected, data can be classified as some different types. So first we can think about calculating, or I'm sorry, we can collect numerical data, or we can collect data that we would refer to as categorical data. Numerical data is data that can be ranked or ordered. Another word that's used to refer to this is quantitative, because it has that root of quantity in it. So numerical data, quantitative data means exactly the same thing, but it's any data that can be ranked or ordered. So if we collect the data on weight, salary, years of education, those would be data values that can be ranked or ordered. There are certain weights that are more than others, salaries that are less than others, years of education that are more or less than others. So whatever those resulting numbers are, they can be ranked and ordered in comparison with each other. Categorical data is data that can't be ranked or ordered. The other word that's used to refer to categorical data is qualitative. And here the root is the word quality. So we're talking about a quality of something, not a quantity of something. So what we mean is that one value isn't better or worse, it's simply different. Things can't be ranked or ordered. So for instance, things like color, if we're talking about hair color, eye color, car color, furniture color, paint color, the job that a person has, the type of car they drive. So anything that's a category but not a number that can be ranked or compared. While there might be some personal preferences that one type of car is better than another, there's no real way to numerically compare those results. So we can consider numerical data, categorical data, depending on what variable we're trying to understand. We can also consider data that comes from the population or data that comes from a sample. And this will be an important distinction throughout our course. So for instance, assume that we want to know how popular electric cars are among 20 to 30 year olds in Illinois. So recently a lot of manufacturers got into the electric car business. Sales weren't as good as they wanted. Some companies have stopped producing those vehicles. Others have offered very generous discounts on their cars from just the model year before. So how popular are these electric cars? Would a company want to consider continuing their production? Should they cease production? So to answer this question, we could collect population data. So if what we're trying to study is information about 20 to 30 year olds in Illinois, and we want population data, then we would need to survey, or through some other means, collect data on every single person in Illinois who's 20 to 30 years old. Doing that would be nearly impossible. It would take a huge amount of money. It would take a significant amount of time. We would have to know who all the 20 to 30 year olds are, even are in Illinois. We'd have to worry about if we are surveying people, are we surveying people who are in Illinois visiting from out of state? Do you actually live here? All sorts of things to take into consideration. So getting population data in this case isn't very realistic. So a more realistic approach would be to survey a sample of 20 to 30 year olds from Illinois. So rather than trying to find every single 20 to 30 year old in Illinois, we would randomly select 20 to 30-year-olds from across the state. Now, that can pose its own problems, but still, even this method of making sure we're getting an equal number of men and women, that people of different ethnicities, different income levels are equally represented, that's still going to be easier than trying to go out and survey every single 20 to 30-year-old in Illinois. Instead, what we'll do is look at a sample. So some group of people that's smaller than the total population. So it might be 1,000 people, 1,500 people, a little more, a little less, but we'll study some smaller group. And then we can use the information from our sample to make inferences about our population. So whenever we do that, there are going to be things to take into consideration. There's obviously going to be some amount of error because we're not surveying everyone. We're making educated guesses based off some sample data. But this is what we refer to as the distinction between descriptive and inferential statistics. If we perform a calculation on population data. So if we did go out and collect data on every single person in Illinois, or if in some other scenario we did have population data, that result, so if we found an average, for instance, we would refer to that result as a parameter. So parameters tell us something about the entire population. If we perform a calculation on a sample, so we take the average of our sample or calculate a percentage for our sample, that result is called a statistic. So, statistic, and our course is statistics. The course statistics, or the problems that we're interested in answering in statistics, are primarily concerned with using sample data. And from that sample data, we generate statistics, using those to make inferences about populations. So this is sort of the big picture of where we're headed overall in this course. The first two exams will cover more descriptive statistics, where we're taking the data that we're looking at and just seeing what information does that data tell us just about the information we've collected. Once we get to the third exam and beyond, then we'll be talking about inferential statistics, using sample data to make some predictions or inferences about population parameters that we don't know. So one way of putting it is, statistics is what we do in this course in statistics is going to turn into a game of trying to make educated guesses about things that we don't know, but basing those guesses off sample data that we've collected that's hopefully come from a sample of randomly selected people who are an accurate representation of the entire population. So there's a lot going on in there, but we'll sort of walk through this step by step. We'll get some basic information down first, talking about first how we just represent data, some different ways of understanding and explaining data before we get into those deeper levels of analysis and the inferential statistics that we'll start getting into for material that's covered on the third exam.